Hi, I'm Denis, and in this video, unfortunately, I'll have to inform you that Product Hunt launch will not save your startup. I know it's very sad, but it's true. All of us initially for our first couple of products have this golden marketing strategy. Go on Twitter, post 15 product updates, go to a couple of forums like Indie Hackers and Reddit to brag about our new product, then build 10-15 more features, come to Product Hunt and get a couple hundred signups. What happens next is, unfortunately, even though you had your Product Hunt launch and had this initial spike in visitors, you haven't built a sustainable business model. And majority of people who I hang out with care about the profit as the main driver for their business. And this is exactly when such marketing strategy fails, because this strategy is great for bringing attention to your product and building hype about it. If you want to go with a freemium version for a couple of years because you saved up a couple years of runway for yourself, sure, this video might not be as useful for you. However, if you intend to make a living out of your product, think twice. I had few startups reach out to me after securing the first place on Product Hunt. What happens is that you get these hundreds of signups into your product, which are majority of them are people checking different products and never care about what you do because they liked your pretty user experience and thought that they want to check it out. 90% of them never return to the product, and just very few convert into paying users. 3 months later, these products which had hundreds of signups and number one place on Product Hunt had less than 10 customers, bringing them just a couple hundred monthly recurring revenue. And this is not what you expect after you invest thousands of dollars into hype, design, landing page, and all this stuff. The alternative way to approach it is, instead of trying to build hype around your product, try to be building sustainable business model. And sustainable business model for your startup comes from a high volume of users paying for it. Early on, you would rather have more people in your startup who are paying for your product. The way we usually scale SaaS startups is we would have 20 users, 20 of which would be paying for the product. This way, we would equally treat all their feedback because all of them are bringing us 19 to a couple hundred dollars a month. And we know it's super low chance that we will go in the wrong direction after listening to their feature requests. Instead of trying to polish your design and user experience, which seems to be super intuitive, better find more customers for your product. This way, you will have more cash flow to improve your UX, you'll have more testimonials to put on your landing page, and then you will have a bigger community to support your Product Hunt launch, to get from 100 paying users and a validated business model towards a couple hundred of them. This is going to be the great stage for you to go with these hype machines. I hope this video was helpful. If you were preparing for a Product Hunt launch yourself, please don't be discouraged by this. Just let me know how it went in the comments. And I'll be uploading many more videos about SaaS in the next upcoming weeks. So just subscribe to my channel and I'll see you here in the next video.